Welcome back, folks.
Yeah, we're back, we're back.
You still like me with Gary?
Astro Clouds.
Astro Clouds,
yeah. And that name, so, is like a double, Astro, night thing, clouds. Right?
Yeah.
There you go, let me go into this here one time now.
Yeah,
because as you say.
Yeah, this is high off the music.
High off the music.
High off the music, yeah, right? So, this piece is dedicated to African and Pan-American women, right? To all the Native women and the women in South America, the Caribbean women,
right?
To all women, right? And is our national piece for like the Pan, representing the Pan and the strength women have,
right?
African women and Pan-American women in the Caribbean and in the world by extension. That's why we all are always using USB cables because it's. It's true, it connect across, right? You will see a bullet in my work because a bullet is not only for violence, and a bullet is about projection and moving forward, right? So what she doing with the Pan, right? And with her whole aura then is moving it forward.
Right.
Because that's what the woman does do. Because I mean, a lot of the times in the Caribbean, we take the Caribbean woman for granted, we take the African woman for granted.
Mm-hmm.
When in reality, she does this propel things forward. You know what I mean? When you come home, when you go home, you're not cooking now. She cooking, you know, she's sorting out the children, you know. She raising the nation, she nurturing the whole nation. I know we always have quotes that, you know, you teach a man, you just teach one person, you teach a woman,
you teach
a whole nation, you know what I mean? So I had to work with this piece because you know, we represent and we're trying to big up the world, uplift all the women.
The African
especially
woman.
In this time where that she gets so much fight down and, you know, so much negativity around coming towards her.
Definitely, I appreciate this.
Yeah. So this is high of the music. So it's dedicated to the Pan-African American woman. Right, and also the steel pan.
Nice.
And the whole thing about the Caribbean and moving forward and connectivity. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
What's your response to something like this? Wherever you might show it or whatever?
People like it, you know, just can't understand it. And it's not a scene. You don't have to understand art then.
That's what I think. If you look at a picture, no matter what it is, you look at a picture, and you use this.
That's all, yeah.
That's all they need to do.
Yeah.
We spent a little time by Studio 66 with Makemba. Makemba have a piece
thing
in a corridor that he say in done it.
Yeah.
Right?
And we mount a thing we see in that 3-4 minutes watching that picture.
Yeah, I said you're watching the picture and you see all kind of thing.
True.
And I saying, but if you watching that and you tell me you can't see nothing, there was something wrong with you.
I always say behind the cameras and thing when you deal with me normal, I wouldn't explain that piece to you.
Right.
Because the saying is this, right? The saying is this, right? If I picked you to speak 1,000 words, will you me tell you again? What you say? I didn't talk here already, you know what I mean? So you wanna just listen.
Yeah.
Listen with your eyes.
Yeah. Okay.
Right? And you listen with your eyes and you get the message. I'm not trying to talk nothing again because I can be contradicting myself. I can be saying like that bullet moving forward when really and truly you think about that bullet trying to hurt somebody.
Yeah.
And it's okay.
Yeah. Because you get that, from it, you get.
Yeah, because really and truly she trying to hurt somebody with the message she carrying out there too with that bullet. Although she moving forward, she's still trying to hurt you. And let you know, yo, don't mess around, be strong like that.
Yeah.
You can get hurt.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So that's what it is. What you see art, whatever you think it is. That's what it is. Well, that's what it is for me.
Right.
What the viewer come at me and say, Gary, this is what I see.
Yeah.
If I do blue and you see pink, well, that's what it is.
Let me give you this one now.
Yeah.
This happened in 1995. My grandfather took me to an exhibition up in Algico building in town.
Right.
I grew up in a house with my grandfather painting proper scenery, things like the Trinidad railways and things that we used to work.
Yeah.
I see these things in full detail and things.
True.
Right? Like the painting I just showed you.
Yeah.
Eric Williams shaking Buzz Butler. Well, no, Eric Williams and Buzz Butler having a conversation.
True.
So we go on in this exhibition. 1995, I was about 15 or 16. A red raw. And I watching the painting and I'm like, this is art. But I think and I talking to myself now.
Yeah. True.
But it come it loud, cause you know it's not loud in an exhibition. People so people here now. And I find it place get quiet and I look around there about 5-6 big people.
Watching it.
Including ministers and they watching me.
True.
Cause as you know, Sina,
yeah,
shouldn't really have to explain something like this.
No.
Right? Because at 15 or 16 I watching them start, I'm like, nothing about it and coming out to me, but when I look at this here,
yeah,
I gained that 1,000 words. And as you say, you could probably put another 1,000 words there. True, you shouldn't have to.
Yeah.
But I actually seen the 1,000 words now.
Yes, yeah.
You know? And I agree that, boy, especially in this time that we're living in, art must talk. They had that talking there.
Yeah.
Kwame Ture, they say you're looking like him.
Yeah. Yeah, I appreciate that, man. I appreciate that. I want to say this one thing though. You might hear me say certain things, but I appreciate all the artists and their work. Mm-hmm. Because I mightn't do still lives, but still lives is recorded history as well.
Yeah. Right.
Because when I do an artwork of a still life or a scenery, mm-hmm. I record that in history.
Right.
So it is important.
Right.
It is important for all the arts, however, right? Dealing with the people I dealing with on the streets or the grounds or the people.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it's beautiful and thing, but sometimes we have no time for beauty.
Yeah.
We just have time to do the work and listen to the hard question, talk about the hard issues, and that's what is right now with some of my works right here.
Right.
Yeah.
So, Gary does also do music.
Yeah.
You know? What you just call him? Rap?
Yeah, I for right now I call it Scataglyphs too, because I ain't developed a name for it yet.
Right.
So I call it the same thing with my art style, Scataglyphs.
Right.
Right? I mean, I just do I wouldn't say it positive or conscious, you know. I just do the same thing what I did in painting.
Mm.
You know what I mean?
Because I have a freestyle from you on my phone that I never deleted.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You wanted it too bright.
Oh, yeah. I get it.
Give me something, man.
Right? So it's kind of too black, too poor, and too vain. Too much liquored up, old hope in new days. Too much, not enough, too much is no gain. Too smart with no brains, too same with no change.
Mm.
Tune up, you're too much heights and no bass. Too caught up, too deep with two names. Too slow pace, we need to make haste. Tools to make way, two roots with no trace. Too bright, still with no flame.
Hmm.
Too well known, too hype with no fame. Too much of a slave to break from these chains, to raise from these drains, too much to explain. Books with no page, souls that no rage. Force that door cage, get high in low days, we slave with low wage. Love could show hate, we ball with no game, we shoot with no aim.
Hmm.
Why? Because I live what I write in. And this is what the people call in liberal writing. Yeah, you have to speak for the Jeez. Right things. You have to know yourself and fight for your civil right thing. Yeah, you know what I mean? Yes, sir. Yeah, thanks for
that. That's what we talk. You see that? And a man pulling a guitar,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah,
I never did that on my phone right
now.
Yeah. And that line is always staying in my head. What?
Yeah.
Too bright with no flame?
Yeah, too bright with no flame.
All right, so yeah, what's this thing? Gary, tell the people and them how to find you.
Right. So you can find me on Astro Clouds on IG,
mm-hmm.
Gary Martin on Facebook, and Astro Clouds on Facebook as well.
Alright.
Right, and my number.
Give me a number as well.
Yeah, my number is 731-3048.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And you will also find me every day on Dinsley Junction, right, by the Quick Shop every day. So you can come through, see my, do my work and everything. Come and have some discussions. And the everyday we welcome.
Come and buy
everybody.
Art.
Yeah.
Come and buy art.
The man just mentioned this quick now. Is he had a series of plant pots he was doing as well.
Yes, of course, yeah.
So you have your plants and things?
Yeah.
You bring your pot for Gary to paint, or you order the pot and thing from him as well?
Yes.
Right. So guys, we've mentioned before that, you know, there's a fantastic opportunity to market your small businesses. I don't like to call them small businesses. Market your businesses on Guile, right, by supporting the station. Right now we have a special, the People's Package, where you get 10 ads a day for 30 days. I would dare you all to find anywhere else
that
you will get that opportunity.
10 right? ads per day
10
for,
ads per day for 30 days. Right? So that's 300 ads.
Hmm.
Right? And the Guile market, the Guile reaches upwards of 30 million throughout the English-speaking, Latin-speaking, Spanish-speaking, Caribbean regionally and through the Flow Network, right? Yeah. Somebody tried to question it the other day.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know.
But I was glad that you could actually show them.
Yeah, so we have the data. The reach is up, is closer to 10 million, right? So if you all need any information on that, feel free to reach out to the afrotunereview@gmail.com. Send an email, put in your caption, the people's package, and we will forward you the details with regards to how much the package costs. It is very affordable, people. I'm not even joking. This is very affordable. But when you reach out to us, we will start the discussion and we will see how we can work with you guys to try to get your, not try, but to get your information and get your products on the Gael table, on the Gael marketplace, so that people will be able to see and support your businesses.
I want to add to that too, and it was involved in this conversation here with Astro Clouds.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody say, Gael, thing, like, yo, why does we have to wait for somebody to put a value to something before we could see it?
Mm-hmm.
And why is it in 2020 when we want to claim, oh, we heading and we is not a third world nation anymore, and them kind of thing. Most of us can't see the value of something like Gael.
Yeah,
true.
And what Gael have inside of it.
Yeah,
of course.
And why we still have to wait for it to be what we call trending before we want to be on the bandwagon.
Yeah.
Nah, we have to be bigger and better than that, boy.
That's right.
This is our opportunity.
Yeah.
You know?
And you all showed it, eh? Don't forget.
Yeah.
You all showed it last year.
We know. We know.
We know that all they believe in it.
How we put it, boy? We know the value without knowing the value.
Right.
You know? Right. Let we don't just stand up for something at the point in time when the fire burning.
And take it too late.
Yeah, you know, we need a big fire tender and helicopter showing down. No.
Mm-hmm.
We have an opportunity here. We have an opportunity to showcase businesses, to improve our business, the business we support, everything.
Yeah. And it's a black-owned business. I mean, it's a no-brainer.
We can't be talking all that talk.
Everybody else business.
Everybody else.
Everybody else business. We lining up in the Chinese food. We lining up in the ice cream. We lining up in the pizza place. Or they couldn't wait for KFC to open.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Lines. Right? I couldn't believe that. After all the memes and all the things I see on Facebook, on social media, and the whole, when these places close,
yeah,
I wasn't ready for
that
walking out the road that day. And passing my KFC and seeing a line so.
Yeah.
People so. I wasn't ready for that.
After they show all that little business.
Yeah, yeah. Ready for that.
Right? They take away the stipend from the people and then when the place shut down. Right? After that, they say they will give them what?
Breads, I don't know. And I don't care. All I say is, I want to quote a friend of ours here. He say,
and raise the prices.
He say, and boy, he say, what he will do is continue the same small businesses that he was eating from.
That's right.
During the lockdown, he needed his business to continue. And if each of us try that, we'll get something different.
Yeah.
Right? I wear Nubian Experience.
Yep.
That is me.
Yep.
You can find me on Facebook and Instagram, the Nubian Experience.
Right?
I wear Davison Watches, a Trinidadian living in New York that does a watch line. Karen Wayne, God Crave the Creative.
Stokwika Michael.
Right?
Yeah.
Gary Wayne, Astro Clouds, hat on the head.
Yes.
And Nubian Experience, Dashiki.
Yeah.
You know? And this is what we want to do. We want to promote that.
Yeah.
We want to promote it because we could talk till we're more dry. If we have money to spend, it's just talk.
Yeah.
It's just talk. And they just laugh at we, you know?
Yeah.
Because everything they just do, is market to us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even if you only have $1,
they want $1.
Yeah.
How come it's so hard for we to market to ourselves, boy? Why, as an African man, why this so hard to get other African people to
wear?
By bringing something with a white man name on it, I know, good. So I will leave only with this, right? I write this a few years ago.
Yeah.
Branded slaves versus slave to brands. During slavery, they used to brand they used to use fire and iron to brand their names on our bodies. Today we pay them to wear their names branded on our bodies.
True.
And that is what we're going on here. We got to change that. We got to change that because in this whole pandemic here, pandemic, however you choose to call it, one of the things I look at and I see is the people that still make money. That's something a certain sector of society never complained about.
No,
they never did.
And we had to look to get into some of them sectors.
Some of them so brazen, they actually closed down their business.
Yes.
You understand?
Because it didn't matter to them. We just had to get into them thing and them boys. Not an overnight process.
Yeah.
It's not an easy process, but we have to get into it. We have to get into it. Exactly. And one of the things we have to start to work our way out of, especially via our children, is the employee mindset. Because this discussion is real hard to have with people who only are accustomed working for other people, who are comfortable with that.
Yeah.
And who have a problem with us saying it because they feel we're trying to destroy their comfort. I'm not trying to destroy nobody's comfort.
Nothing wrong with that if you choose to work for somebody for the rest of your life.
But see the vision. See the vision. Yeah. And see how important it is now. Yeah.
And see the importance of your dollars.
Yeah.
Right? We can't achieve economic power with all that. Right? We are the number one spenders in the world.
Yeah.
On, listen, you can't even...
Everybody markets to us.
That's right.
In America, the people that has made the most money off a false hair don't wear false hair. And that false hair market is targeted at African women. How? At least be involved in the industry where you're making them kind of billions too now.
Yeah, correct.
You know? Correct. None of them just do nails and fingernails and toenails like we, but them running the businesses that doing that. We had to get into them thing and them. I'm not saying we don't do it here.
Yeah.
But it had to be bigger.
Yeah.
It have to be bigger.
Yeah.
Right? So support black business. Support our black business is a hashtag that we just use.
Yeah.
Support AH black business. You know, tag them thing on social media. Let we get some kind of something trending. Support Gael. Support Gael. Support Gael. We mean begging.
Nah, we mean begging.
We're saying something that is necessary.
Yeah.
Gael is necessary.
Yeah.
Right. And we offering through this is beneficial to the people who will take part in it as well.
That's right. So folks, all you follow us on social media, we have a YouTube page, The Afrochini View, Instagram, The Afrochini View, Facebook, The Afrochini View, and the email is theafrochiniview@gmail.com. Send all the requests for the advertising information. I am the person managing the email, so I will respond to y'all.
Quickly.
And if you need help in terms of filming your 30-second advert something,
say all of that.
Say all of that to us and we will help you with it, alright?
Yeah.
So we out.
To the next one, Gary.
Hey, thanks a lot, you know.
It was our honor to
have you. Let's say hi up loud,
yeah? Yeah, man.
More life for you. Goodness, be safe for you.